Thanks, everybody. It's a real pleasure to be here with you this morning. I'm Paul Levine with Trulia. We're based in San Francisco in the heart of Silicon Valley. We're a leading online real estate site that reaches 22 million home buyers and home searchers each month. Before I get started, quick show of hands, how many folks in the audience have moved in the last 5 years, moved houses? All right, keep your hands up. Tell me if moving was one of the most time-consuming, information-intensive, and frustrating processes you've been through in a long time. All right, I'm here to tell you you're not alone, and that Trulia is here to help you using open government data to help you make smarter decisions about where to live. I'm gonna start with a blank screen. I'm gonna start with a personal story here about my own move recently. So about 18 months ago, my wife and I and our two kids, actually before I joined Trulia, were looking for a place to live, living in the Bay Area, and really three things factored into our move. One, we were looking for a great school district for our two young kids. My daughter was just starting kindergarten. Two, we were looking for a safe neighborhood where we wanted to raise our family and could imagine living for years and years in peace and safety. And then three, we were looking for an easy place for our commute, try to find a way to live in a great neighborhood and then also have a wonderful commute. And I'll tell you, at that point in time, even just a couple years ago, it was hard to find this information. There were little bits and pieces of it out there, but nobody really pulled it together and integrated it in a way that could help the average consumer make smart decisions. Enter Trulia. Our focus as a company is to provide home searchers and renters the inside scoop to find their best place to live. And again, some of these factors, like safety and commute, are major factors in the decision. So over the last couple years, working together with open government data, a lot of it provided by the White House's Safety Data Initiative, and amazing work done by innovators at Trulia, including Shaw. Where's Shaw? Raise your hand, Shaw. Shaw will be speaking later on the agenda. Like Madonna and Bono, Shaw is so talented that he goes by only one name. A lot of the work that you'll see here is work that Shaw and our innovative team in Silicon Valley has done. So let's get to it. A couple of examples. Trulia Crime Map. So again, over the last couple years, we've done a lot of work internally to leverage open government data. So in this case, we're taking data from that's provided by local law enforcement agencies, some of it directly, some of it aggregated via partners like Crime Reports and Spot Crime, and then across the country are providing crime maps. So city by city, zip code by zip code, users can come in and understand where the safer areas and where the areas where crime tends to happen. So here's a map of overall Washington, D.C. You can see areas where, you know, it's a heat map. Again, areas that are red tend to have high crime. Areas that are green tend to have less crime. And again, it just sort of gives you an overview as you scan a neighborhood to figure out where you might want to live and where are some of the safer places to live. Now, the interesting thing about crime, though, is that not all crimes are the same, right? You tend to find in areas of high urban density lots of crime like pickpocketing, bike theft. These are not great, but in the overall flavor of crime, not all crimes are the same, again. So we actually created a violent crime heat map that show you that the areas that have the most crime overall are not necessarily the areas that have the most violent crime. And so as folks figure out which neighborhoods they want to live in, which parts of the country they want to live in, they can then make informed decisions about where are the safest neighborhoods. And when they think about safety, again, it's not a one-dimensional thing. They can think about crime overall, and can think about, can understand where violent crimes occur. And again, these heat maps are created using our innovative software and design skills, but leveraging data that's provided openly out on the market. So those are Trulia's crime maps. Next, I'll show you Trulia's commute maps. So as, again, for many folks, their commute is a major factor in where they want to live. And so we've created commute maps as well. The typical use case, if you think about someone who's just taken a new job and is thinking about moving related to the job, is they sort of drop a pin on a map and say, okay, this is where my place of work is going to be. Now, where do I want to move to make sure that I have a convenient commute? So what we've done is essentially automate that process using open data. So really two major data sources that power these commute maps that we've created. One is U.S. Census Bureau's Tiger data. So we're able to determine commute times and commute lengths for highway driving and road driving. And then we also have taken data from local public transit authorities, much of which is available on data.gov, and figured out commutability for people searching for homes. So again, back to our example. So we took an example here of someone who works at the AP Bureau in downtown Washington. And if you want to do, if you'd like to have a commute that's 15 minutes or less using public transit, you can just type that into our interface. By the way, this is both on our website and on our 9 mobile apps that we've got. And you can figure out if I want to live within 15 minutes of this job, then there's a certain radius around this place of work that you can then live. Now this will make for a great commute, less than 15 minutes. I wish I had a 15-minute commute myself. But it sort of limits the geographic options, right? You have a certain set of neighborhoods that you can live in. If you're willing to expand to a 45-minute commute, then you just do one slide of the dial, and you can see all of the areas around you that are within 45 minutes from your place of work. So this then means you'd be willing to have a longer commute, but it just opens up a ton more options for you in terms of where you want to live. Now, Maryland, Northern Virginia are in reach. It gives you a lot more options. So those are our crime maps and then our commute maps. Just a couple more examples. I'm going to tell you a story. So one of the most exciting things about my job is I hear stories every day about consumers who are using our services and how they really help them live better lives and make smarter decisions. So here's an example. Sean and Tracy with their two young kids. Actually, both folks who have served our country in the U.S. military, 6 and 4 years respectively, who are now leaving Arizona and looking for a place to live in the D.C. metro area. And like me, they had many of the same factors. These are very common factors that people think about when they want to choose a place to live: a good school district, a safe neighborhood, and a manageable commute. So they've been using Trulia's tools to try to find those three things that they're looking for, and also find a home that's within the price range that they're looking for. And they've narrowed in on this area here, and are, again, using Trulia to find a great place to live, leveraging open data provided by the government. So exciting for us. We hear stories like this every day, and it really is inspiring for us and for our product development team. But not only is it good for consumers, it's great for our business as well. So one example, when we launched our crime apps, which is about a year ago, in the first couple days, 500,000 people visited our site. They saw press releases, they saw blog posts, brought a spike in traffic to our site. So not only is this great for consumers, but it's also great for our business, which obviously is exciting for us. So to wrap up, we're very thankful for all of the data that's provided out there, free open government data. We're very proud of the innovations that Shaw and other folks inside our company have done. And we thank you for the opportunity to be here.